Hello everyone, in this video we will learn about vehicle routing problem, that is classical optimization challenge in transportation that involves finding the most cost effective and time efficient routes for vehicle to serve a set of customers. Suppose we have a delivery company with 5 trucks and this company needs to deliver package to 20 different locations. So here the objective is to minimize the total travel distance or cost while ensuring that each truck does not exceed its capacity and all deliveries are completed within the requested time. Solving vehicle routing problem is challenging because it is an NP-hard problem, means it become very difficult to solve as the number of customer increases. Here you can see different variations. Depending on the problem, we have special type of VRP. Like first we have CVRP, that is capacitated VRP. Here vehicle load capacity is considered because trucks has limited capacity. So each vehicle has a limit on how much it can carry. So here we need to plan accordingly so that no vehicle is overloaded. So for example, we have a truck and this can carry only 100 kg of goods. So if customer demanding 200 kg, then you have to divide the delivery into 2 trucks to avoid overloading done. Second, we have BRP with time window. So in such problem, customer want the delivery at specific time. So deliveries must happen within the specific time frames. So here we need to plan the routes to make sure that packages arrive within those time periods. For example, if one customer wants a delivery between 9 to 11 a.m. and another need it in between 1 to 3 p.m. So here your routes must ensure that you follow these schedules. Third, we have dynamic VRP. So in dynamic environments, things can change while vehicle are already on their way, like new order coming in or traffic jam. For example, the driver is halfway on their routes and a new delivery request appear. So here we need to reroute the vehicle. So here you can see each variation making the problem more complex. So depending on the problem, we need efficient routes that lower fuel cost, faster deliveries, happy customers, and also reduce the environmental impact. In vehicle routing problem, what we are doing, we are trying to find out the most effective route for number of vehicles to travel in order to deliver goods or services to a number of clients while satisfying number of constraints. Here constraints, we have certain restriction. So objective is here to minimize the total route cost, and here this involves minimize total distance, time travel and other factor while satisfying constraint. Constraint like vehicle cannot carry more than its capacity. Second, every customer must be visited exactly once. So here you can see vehicle routing problem, basic components, depot, customer, fleet, constraints. Depot, that is the starting and the ending point for all vehicles. Customers, that is location that require service like delivery or pickup. Fleet, that is a number of available vehicles for routing, and we have here each vehicle with XYZ capacity. Then we have constraint. Constraints are like restrictions, or we can say limitations, like vehicle capacity, time window, or we have maximum route length. Objective is here to minimize total distance, time, cost while satisfying all the constraints. Here you can see in this graph we have nodes and edges. So nodes representing the depot and customer locations, edges representing the possible path between the nodes, and edges are often labeled with cost such as distance or time. Here you can see we have depot D, and this is connected to customer C1 and C5. So here different color edges are used to represent the routes for different vehicle. For example, you can see this red edge means vehicle 1 serves C1 and C2 customer. Then you can see this blue one, it means vehicle 2 serving customer 3 and customer 4. Then the green one, it means vehicle 3 is serving customer 5. Done. This is a simple problem. Your goal is to minimize the cost while satisfying the customer demand, ensuring that each customer is served, and at the same time we are also minimizing the cost. So we have different challenges here. Sometimes some customer need their delivery at specific time. Second, when we have many customers, many trucks, then finding the best solution for all is complicated, because we need the best solution for both customer and company. Company want to save time, cost, fuel by delivering their services, and customer need the delivery on time done. And third one, each truck has limited capacity. So we have different challenges that we need to keep in mind while solving the vehicle routing problem. And using simple method, finding the best solution for this problem can be hard. So we can use advanced method to find good solution for this problem. And you know, vehicle routing problem is advanced version of traveling salesman problem, because in traveling salesman problem, we have single salesperson visiting all cities once and returning to the starting point. In vehicle routing problem, it involves multiple vehicles serving customer from a depot. So we have different key features. So we have multiple vehicle. So vehicle routing problem involve a fleet of vehicles starting and ending at a central depot. Then we have customer constraint. Each customer must be visited exactly once by only one vehicle. And here you can see customers are located at nodes in a network. So objective is to minimize the cost. And when we will minimize the cost, it means we have to minimize distance, minimize time, minimize the fuel consumption. So goal is to, we have to find out the optimal solution of routes for all vehicles so that all the customers are served within minimal total cost. In simple words, we can say vehicle routing problem is about planning the best way to deliver items from a central location to different customers using a fleet of vehicles. And this problem appears in many real world situations like garbage collection, parcel delivery, milk floats delivering, and other like school bus routes and many. To solve vehicle routing problem, we need to make sure that all the customers are served, means every customer must receive their delivery on time, and we have to follow certain rules. For example, every vehicle has a limited capacity, means how much it can carry, and also the driver cannot work forever. There is a limit on their working hour. So we have to keep in mind this also. And finally, we have to achieve the objective, that is minimize the cost. The goal is to minimize the total transportation cost. So either we can design the algorithm that can effectively find the best solution, or we can use any advanced method. Then next we have different decision variables and dependent variables. So we have independent and dependent variables. So the solution is often determined by the decision variables. So once the graph is created, we will build the distance matrix. This matrix contains the shortest distance or time between every pair of node, that is between two customer or a customer and depot. So as we already discussed, it is an NP hard problem, and solving this problem is challenging, because vehicle routing problem will become more complex as the number of customers grow and finding the best solution become expensive. So here we can use different advanced methods like meta heuristic algorithms. They are used because they provide good solution in a reasonable amount of time. Even for the large problems that would be too hard for the simple methods to handle, we can apply meta heuristics. So here you can see different meta heuristic algorithm that we can apply to solve vehicle routing problem, like ant colony optimization. Next we have taboo search, simulated annealing, particle swarm optimization, and other. So meta heuristic algorithm combine two strategies, also try to explore different parts of the solution space to avoid getting stuck in the suboptimal solution, that is the local optima. So meta heuristic balance both exploration and exploitation. So here we have proper balance between speed and the solution quality, that is making them more suitable for solving large and real world problems. So they can explore different possible plans in more depth and ensure that we can find a good solution without taking too long. So here you can see different applications across various industries. In food delivery, this is used to optimize the delivery path for the restaurants and food service provider. In healthcare, home healthcare services. In telecommunication, so we can use different heuristic algorithms to solve vehicle routing problem because they are designed to handle complex, large-scale optimization problems that have multiple variables and constraint. For example, genetic algorithm, here each potential solution, that is a vehicle route, is represented as chromosome. Then in ant colony optimization, this algorithm is inspired by how ants find the shortest path to the food source using pheromone trail. So while solving vehicle routing problem, here each ant is a vehicle that will build routes. So each ant construct a route based on pheromone level and distance. Then we will update the pheromones and repeat the process. In PSO algorithm, we can simulate how particles move through the search space to find the best solution. So why we are using metaheuristic for solving this problem? Because they provide us near optimal solution quickly, even when the problem is complex and large. And because this algorithm can solve large scale problems with many customer and vehicles, and they adapt to different constraints and objective like minimizing cost and balancing workload. In next video, we will try to understand how we can solve vehicle routing problem using metaheuristic algorithm. So we will apply any metaheuristic algorithm on this problem. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.